Karma here, and today I'm going to give you guys an update on my first maybe 2 months of teaching so far ever. And I know I've been slacking on my teaching videos, but I have to get back on it. I'm gonna get back on it. It's just been kind of hectic because it was the beginning of school and it's also my first year of teaching, so I'm learning everything as we speak. So here we go, here's an update and stay tuned. Okay, so the first thing that I want to mention, and by the way, I'm going to go pretty fast. I'm not going to go 100% into details, but I just want to knock out maybe 5 things that I'm learning. The first thing would have to be the paperwork. So I do teach pre-K kinder special education and specifically autism, kids who have autism. So I'm learning about, you know, lesson plans, the TEKS. I'm in the state of Texas, so we have the TEKS. ARDS and IEP goal writing. Man, all that stuff is so time consuming. And I know those things vary by school, by state. But at my school, I even heard that at some schools, the lesson plans are already made for teachers. They just implement them. But at mine, we have to make our lesson plans. So It's kind of like trying to learn all that stuff at once. I'm barely, you know, into this, you know, 2.5 months in, and I still have yet to master those things. But it is a learning process, and I have plenty of help. I've been at this school for 3 years, 2 years as a TA, and this is my 3rd year as a teacher. So I already knew the people, knew the staff, knew the administration. It wasn't like something I had to learn as far as learning the people and the paperwork. It was more like I already know who to go to for anything that I need. So the support there was very good, especially with the other teachers. The next thing is the Texas Teachers Program that I'm going through. Now, some of you all that were watching, we're either going through the same program or interested in going through this program. Right now, I'm in my probationary period. I think I'm going to have to make a separate video about Texas teachers because that in itself is pretty lengthy, but I will touch on it. And right now we have assignments that we have to do during our probationary period, and it's about 7 assignments plus other things. But out of the 7 assignments, I've only really completed 1. So I need to get caught up on that, and I plan on getting caught up on that within the next 2 months. I want to get all those assignments done. So, but I will come back to you guys to that in another video, and because I know a lot of people had questions about it. So I will get to that hopefully next week. I will upload a video about Texas teachers. The next thing is parent communication and legalities about some things, because certain things you can't say, do, or whatever with a parent. And I already knew about this before as a TA, but I've just learned more about it now as a teacher, even more about it. So that helps a lot. And even some things like you would like to give advice to a parent about certain things, but you can't. And I already knew that, you know, last year as a TA, but I think I'm going to forever be, you know, figuring out other ways to effectively communicate with parents, as any teacher should be, and not just with parents, but with coworkers, students, admin, you know, like, I think effective communication is something that we're forever going to be evolving in. So that is another thing that I have been working on. Another thing that I've learned so far is that my TA, my teacher assistant, who I've worked with last year, is such an amazing help. Like, you guys don't understand how much a TA, depending on the kind of TA you have, because some TAs aren't all that great, but the one that I have is awesome. And she takes initiative. She wants to be a teacher one day too. So it's awesome to have someone that plans to be in your shoes, and she wants to go to the same program that I'm going through. So she's eager to learn new things, and I like that about her. Some TAs are not that way. They're kind of just like fly, you know, like whatever kind of job. I know I used to be a TA, so I get it. But my TA has been so much help with how crazy it's been. There's been some times that I've been zoned out or whatever, and she pulls everything through. And I love that about her. So I was fortunate enough to end up with an awesome TA. So the support for this from the TA is great. Like it really is great. The last thing is my personal life. Now I've heard that with teachers, their personal lives are gone. And I've heard that some aren't. Some balance, their personal life and work life. So I really think it depends on the school you teach at, the kind of class you have, and the support that you have. I think all that stuff goes into, the pot of what makes your personal life either present or absent. And at my school, there are teachers that have, not much personal life, and there are teachers that have plenty. And I fall into a place where at the beginning of school, everything was hectic. I had no real personal life because I'd be at school early and trying to do ARD paperwork and stuff. And then after all the ARD stuff was gone, now I'm kind of working on lesson plans. So it's kind of balanced itself out. I still manage to have a personal life. I have to get my Texas teacher stuff done, but I still manage to have my personal life. But I know that at the end of the school year, I won't have a personal life because I have to go through all those ARDs again and with all of my kids. I only have 7 kids, so I know that that makes a difference. If other teachers' caseloads are a lot bigger, I completely see the stress. I was stressing when I was trying to do 2 kids' ARDs, like at the beginning of the year. I was like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, I'm learning at the same time, but then I have a deadline. So it was crazy for me. So I can see why teachers may not have a personal. I can clearly see it. But I'm trying to effectively balance work life and personal life. So I told myself if I really have something that I need to get done, if there's a deadline or whatever the case may be, I need to get to work early. Whether that's 30 minutes earlier or whether that's an hour earlier, I need to get to work earlier. Because I don't want to stay late. I live across town. There's traffic after a certain time. Sometimes we have meetings. Like, I don't want to stay late. So I'm going to get there earlier. Other than that, when I get home, I dedicate maybe 1 to 2 hours of school stuff. After that, I stop. I don't have, any children. So I can see why, if you had kids, why it'd be challenging. I don't have a husband or a boyfriend. So for me, it's me. I'm just a lone ranger. So I can see if you had a family to tend to, how that would affect your personal life. I don't have any kids, and I see it now. Like, dude, would I really be able to take care of a kid right now? Like, I don't think so. So I completely get it. Like, I 100% get it, and I know what it felt like when I was like going in early to figure out paperwork and all of that. But right now my personal life is I try to keep it balanced. Like, I try to keep it balanced. I think that if it ever came to a point where my personal life was non-existent, then I'd really reconsider my job choice because at the end of the day, I come first and my health and my well-being and my mental state is something that I pride, I take pride in and I want to take care of. So right now things are fine as far as personal life and work. I actually have some stuff that I need to do now after I'm done uploading this video. So but I think that's it. Like, if y'all have any questions about my teaching life, please feel free to ask me. Like, I'm willing to engage in that conversation with you, as well as if you have any video ideas in relation to teaching that you would like to know more about. I know I'm going to do the Texas teachers video, but other than that, if you would like to learn anything else and have video ideas, please do share that with me. I would genuinely appreciate it. But please subscribe, comment, like, whatever, do what you need to do. And I'll come back to you guys. Hopefully within a week with another video about the Texas teachers. And I will go more into depth about that. So, other than that, I holla. Bye.